Hello and welcome to the weekly financial modeling tips by the Startup Station. Today we're going to learn how to calculate price by usage tiers for enterprise clients. And what we're going to do specifically is to formulate the pricing strategy. So what we need to consider here is the number of tiers, the average number of users per tier, the percentage of the time that each tier is bought, years 1 to 5, if we're building 5-year projections, as well as price per user, undiscounted, and a discount per tier so that we can calculate a proper price. Okay, so let's see how we're gonna get this done. So here we have our undiscounted price per user, you know, not enterprise clients, $5. We have three types of clients or three tiers with the number of users ranging from 100 to 5,000. Here we have the discount that also ranges from 20 to 40%. And this is the probability that each tier will be bought. Now the question is, how did I get these numbers? So the price per single user, that would come from your pricing strategy. And as you're defining your enterprise pricing, you need to think about what types of clients you're going to contact and what is your expectation in terms of when you're going to convert which clients. So on average, right, you will convert smaller clients more often and larger clients less often, right? Once you get real data, you can put real numbers in here. At the moment, as long as it's a logical expectations, it's fine. The discount is also discretionary, so it's whatever makes sense within your business model and within your price structure. So first, let's calculate the tier price. This will be the price per single user times 1 minus the discount times the number of users. I'm gonna piece that down. And so you immediately see that this enterprise pricing is very profitable. You make a lot of money once you sell even one client. So the next thing to do is to figure out when you convert a client, an enterprise client, you don't want to model specifically which tier it is. You want to estimate how much money you're gonna make on average. And the way to do it is to utilize the sum product function between the tier prices and the probability that each tier is going to occur. And in this case, you are going to make $42.50 on average with this pricing scheme. And there we go. If you like this video, please comment below, share with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to the Startup Station's YouTube channel for more financial modeling tips every week. If you want to learn how to model early stage ventures, we have a free masterclass. The link is in the description. Please go there, sign up, and learn how to model your venture in a way that's credible to investors. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week.